So today's program is a teapot program. So good afternoon once again. Let me start the session, today's session. Good morning once again. Good afternoon. So let me start the session, today's session. The today's session is on the teapot program. So as of now, we have covered the around 7 programs in our lab sessions. So Bresenham's line drawing, rotation of a triangle, spin cube, and one more perspective weaving. That is positioning the camera. Then we have covered up this Cohen-Sutherland. Then lighting and shading. This has been covered up. Then we have with the last 2 programs. That is a teapot. This is the 6th one program that we are going to do. In fact, we need to have some of the concept of lighting and shading, though I'm going to do it in immediately in next 2 sessions. This along with the 3-dimensional transformation functions. So lighting and shading, I'm going to cover it up. So, and also the last is Bezier curve. So if you could come to the syllabus, you have a Bezier curve concept to be studied here. In the 5th module, so that is Bezier spline surfaces, Bezier curve. So though one of the important concept with the module 5, so that with that concept we are going to cover that thing. And also this teapot program requires a concept of few of the concepts of weaving and few of the concepts of ambient light illumination, ambient what is diffuse reflection. So this we are going to see in the next few sessions, right? So coming to the teapot program, let me explain what exactly the teapot program is. So teapot program is basically one of the program wherein you have to draw a particular primitive. In fact, this is a very simple teapot program. So we have one more program where we have a wall surfaces that is being covered. I'll show you the output of that, both the 2 programs. So this program has been shortened just for the sake of understanding. So what we have done is, so we have created a cube-like structure, this rectangular structure, identifying the dimensions of it. We have fixed up the positions of these 4 legs, and we have kept a teapot with respect to the position of this table. So teapot is a basic built-in function. So let me go to the program first. Program, in fact, it consists of lot many built-in functions and lot of things that you need to memorize just to display a very simple thing, right? So I have both the programs. Let me go with a short program. So you have 2 arguments to be passed. Then calling the display mode. Window size 500, init position 00, create the window, init function. So what is init function over here? It is not that only you load the identity matrix or GL ortho functions in init. So you have lot many effects, that is shading effects, that are going to be called, and you call the display function, right? When you call the display functions, so let me not focus on, if you want to see the init functions. So initialized functions here consist of lot many parameters, that is lighting effect, that is ambient, diffuse. These are the initializations that are made. So positions, all these things you have to write as it is in order to get the output of a teapot. If you vary it, the color effect will change. That's it. The color effect will change. So these are the initialization with respect to the variables L ambient, L diffuse, specular, position. So we are going to set up ambient, diffuse, specular, and the position of the light source, that is effect of the light, by using the light function GL light FV, right? So all is a built-in functions. Nothing you are going to change this, right? This is for a ambient. We have a diffuse and we have a component functions for the material properties, right? So to enable smooth, even if you comment also, you will get the output. It is not that if I comment all these things, you are going to get the output. The problem with the commenting is that you may not be able to see the effect of the particular image that is being viewed. Okay. So all these things, exceptionally, GL matrix mode, GL projections, loading the identity matrix, GL ortho. This is mandatory in init function. So all of you know it. Why do we use GL clear color? So to clear the screen. So we use a GL clear color always in the init function. We do call ortho function, right? So x min, x max, y min, y max, z min, z max, loading the identity matrix in order to set up the matrix setup. And we have a projection matrix. So this is a basic thing. We have called projection matrix in all the programs, but one of the important matrix that is being called in this is a model view. This is a major difference in the other programs to this OpenGL program. We have called model view matrix in the display function rather than calling the projection. So projection simply we have called an init function, all these things. So rest of the things in init function, whatever is called, is mandatory to have an effect of ambient, diffuse. These are all the lighting effects, that is illumination effects. So ambient, diffuse, specular components, right? This is for ambient light, this is for a diffuse light, this is for material properties of the light and to enable shading. So I suggest you comment it and run it. You will try to understand if you don't use Lito. So what happens if you don't use the depth paste? What happens? So this could be analyzed by commenting all the effects of the image. Basically, now coming to the main thing, coming to the display function. So display function deals with first loading the model view matrix, right? Clearing the buffer bit and depth buffer for hidden surface removal, loading the identity matrix. See, we have load identity matrix both in the display function and also in the init function, and calling a viewer. A viewer look at is a camera function, that is, it uses the parameters like this. So let me go, what is the look at function does? So you know what is look at function. So you have ix, iy, iz, center x, center y, center z, up x, up y, up z. This function we have used in one of the program which is called perspective viewing of a cube. I hope I remember I had explained what is GL look at function. So it defines a transformation called viewing transformation, right? So the parameters are ix, iy, iz, at x, at y, at z. It could be said at also, instead of center, at x, at y, at z, up x, up y, up z. So we have a specifies the position of the eye point, specifies the position of the reference point, up x specifies the direction of the up vector. Okay. Similarly, we have few of the function that is being used, push matrix, pop matrix, and what is push matrix, what is a pop matrix, what is translate, what is scale. So let me go to the program and explain, or else again you will have a confusion. In the display function, ultimate objective is to call a solid teapot with a dimension called 2. So this is a built-in function to draw a solid teapot, glut solid teapot. From the library called glut, solid teapot is a built-in function to draw a solid pot. To draw a solid pot, nothing else. You are not going to draw anything from on your own. It is a built-in function. When you call solid teapot, it automatically draws with the size of 1. When you go on enlarging the size, we will see while execution of this. Right, setting the camera parameter is through the look at function, the display, after loading the identity matrix and the model view matrix. See, we are using model view matrix instead of any other matrix that we have used. Maybe we have used model view matrix in the perspective viewing, not in any other program we have used model view. We have used model view matrix in the perspective viewing, where we have used look at function there also, right? Next, coming to the calling solid teapot within what? Push matrix, pop matrix. Now I'll explain what is this push matrix. Is it mandatory to write GL solid teapot within push and pop? If you don't write, what happens? That is also important. Similarly, you call solid teapot, you call a table. What is table? table, the structure of a table within push matrix, pop matrix. Only this is the main thing that you have to analyze in this. Flush, you know, always at the end of display, you flush in order to clear the buffer and to be flush out the primitives to be displayed on the screen. So this is the main thing, GL push matrix, solid teapot, pop matrix. GL push matrix, you call table, pop matrix. See, if you could see this function. So this is a solid teapot, GLU by using GL of the size 1 we have called. It is placed at one of the position. After that, what you have called? You have called a table. You have called a table. GL push, pop, GL push, solid teapot, pop, GL push, table, pop matrix. Now, coming to the what is push matrix, what is pop matrix? See, the push matrix basically what it does is push and pop the current matrix. What is there in the current matrix? The current matrix is a model view matrix. So we are not going to affect the existing matrix that is a model view matrix for any kind of sake. So we do call a push matrix. Okay. What it does? It pushes the current matrix down by one, that is by duplicating the current matrix. Hence, we have the duplication of the current matrix. It pushes the current matrix stack down by one and duplicating the current matrix. That is, after a push matrix call, what happens is matrix on the top of the stack is identical to the one. That is, it will create a copy of it so that nothing has to be changed. No manipulations has to be done to the model view matrix. Similarly, pop matrix pops the current matrix from the stack. It replaces the current matrix with the one below on the stack. So we do any sort of animation or any sort of picture that is being called. So first, you need not to affect the current matrix. So in order not to affect the current matrix, what you will do, you will push the matrix. Basically, what it does, it pushes the model view matrix down by one and creates a copy of the current matrix. After certain manipulation, again, that is manipulation means after drawing the teapot, again, you have to pop it up. So pop, push, you have to do the pop matrix. What does the pop matrix do? Pops the current matrix stack. That is by it replaces the current matrix with the one below that has been on the stack. Okay. So this is all the push and pop matrix. Now coming to the what is translate. So we have a translate functions. You know what is translation? Change in the dimension, right? Translate function, what it does, it multiplies the current matrix by the translation matrix. And what are the parameters? It uses x, y, z, GL translated or GL translated f, right? Specifies the x, y, and z coordinates of the translation vector. Similarly, when you scale, scale multiplies the current matrix by the general scaling matrix. The parameters are x, y, z. Specify the factors x, y, z along the various axes respectively. So as shown you the look at function. Now coming to the teapot function. When the solid teapot is called, it is a built-in function. So that is being fetched into the memory. Again, you call a table. Now the major idea is to draw a table. So table consists of a solid. See, when you call table, again, what is to be drawn? You need to draw solid cube of the dimension called 10, size 10. How do you draw it? Again, you do certain sort of animations, that is transformations. It is not animation, it is a transformations. That is, you'll call translate along y-axis, scale along x-axis, y-axis, z-axis. You draw the solid cube and you do the push matrix, pop matrix. Again, see, keep the current matrix, push, pop, within which you have to translate, scale, and solid cube. This draws the upper part of the table, the top of the table. Then you have to draw four legs. At what position you have to draw? So that is table leg. Translate it along x, y, z. You call the table leg. Again, translate it by x, y, z. Call a table leg, right? This is for the second leg, this is for the third leg, fourth leg, and then you do the pop matrix. It is not that we are push pop for individual leg. For all the legs, once at a time, you will push the current matrix. Then you set up the positions of these legs. Translate it, put one leg over here. Translate it, put the same leg. What is table leg? Basically, table leg is also one of the solid cube, right? Within push pop, you have written, it consists of the dimensions, translate, scale, and a solid cube of size 5, right? Try to analyze the program. Let me go to the two programs what we have. So first program, a very simple program, I just want to execute you. See, this is a program that the thing that you have to analyze over here. So let me change the size of it and let me make sure that you understand. See, I said GL teapot is, these are all the effects. See, if you comment also, you could see the differences, right? For example, if I comment this lighting, the effect of the lighting, the background effect will go off. In the teapot, if I do a solid teapot of 2, I'll just change the size of it. See, two teapot, what happens? The dimension of teapot is going to change here, whereas the table is going to shrink. Table is going to shrink. If I keep 3, see, the teapot becomes bigger and the table becomes very small. See, you could see the base of the teapot that is being affected as if it has kept inside the table. So this is because of the effects that we have written in init function, right? So similarly, if I could show you, so I've changed the teapot dimension. Now, if I see table into the legs, the basic leg size is 5, solid cube of 5. So if I change it to 3, the table legs, you could see the difference, the positions of the table legs will change. See? The positions have changed. That means what? You could see there is a disconnectivity between these all the 4 legs because I changed the dimension. I changed the size of this legs. So it has been written as per the size, right? Again, a table top. So table top, it is also solid cube of 10. I can reduce the size or else I can reduce the table size to maybe 15. Now you could see the difference. See, the table size has become large in such a way that you could not see certain effects. So effects has been changed. So this you have to remember. Now coming to your concept, remember, we are going to explain it once again in the transformations. It is totally a concept of transformation wherein we translate scale. We translate scale everywhere whenever you draw a solid cube. Once again, see here, those not... whatever the primitive that is being drawn. So the truth for the, frankly speaking, the primitive here is a solid cube of size 5. It is for a table leg. When it is drawn, always it is a kind of transformation. It is a kind of transformation. This transformation has to be written within the push matrix, pop matrix. So this translation is for the x-axis, y-axis. That is, what is GL translated function does? GL translated function, what it does? Multiplies the current matrix by the scaling matrix. Similarly, GL translated, it multiplies the current matrix with the translation matrix. While drawing tabletop also, it is a solid cube of 10, right? Translate scale within push pop. Again, when you draw 4 table legs, these are all the various positions. Remember, these are all the various positions. You are simply translating. You are not scaling it. You are translating. you are translating, and again you are translating. After Snartly, you draw the table leg of size the same what you have upper side you have specified, table leg of size called 5. See, table leg of the size called 5, that is a solid cube. See, table leg you have called table leg, and in between you push the current matrix and you pop the current matrix in order to get the, not to affect the existing matrix, right? And whereas for here, so tabletop is of size 10, remember table legs are size of 5, so you could see here, I'll just resize, you could see if I comment all these things, that is GL shade smooth, you could see GL lighting, you will not get the after all effect what you have. Okay, depth test is needed. Okay, you cannot comment it. See the changes. Since I have commented all the, these are all the effect of the lighting. That's it. I simply commented what is commented. In order for smooth shading, I need GL shade mode. So for enable lighting, so lighting effect. See. See again. I will enable the lighting effect. Lighto. See, this effect has gone, come back. See, if I comment this Lighto function as a comment, what will be the changes? See, you will not have certain lighting effect. So you could see the diminishing effect, Lighto function. So this is what I'll enable. Lighto function, LIGHTO, Lighto function. It enables the light source. Similarly, these are all the functions. If I comment material effect, that is light properties of the, so you can see the difference. Certain effect you may not be able to analyze when you see of the material properties. Frankly speaking, this you could comment all these things. What is that? Light controlling the diffusion, ambient effect or the diffuse effect. To have a gray color, we have written this. To have a gray, right? Whereas these are all the for the material properties, okay? This is mandatory for your program. So what I suggest is you execute this program and try to understand why do we use a push matrix and pop matrix. If you don't use push matrix, pop matrix, what happens? You see, even that is also one of the concept here. For example, see, if I remove this push or pop, you may not be able to get the table. Okay, I'll comment it. See, I have commented for a table. Majorly, we have to comment here. Okay, that is a table leg. See, you are not able to picturize one of the table since I have not done push matrix, pop matrix in one of the function called table leg. In the one of the function called table leg, I was not able to push or pop. So that was the major thing. At that time, this primitive will not be drawn. Similarly, if you think of a tabletop, here, push matrix, pop matrix. See, again, you are not able to analyze the proper table. So that means it is hidden. The current matrix is hidden that time. So always, whatever the primitive that you have to draw, that has to be drawn within the push matrix and pop matrix. Okay. So this is just for the sake of understanding. I'll forward the program. You execute this program, TPOT program, and we left with the last program called Bezier curve. Even for that, we need to cover up the theory. Bezier curve. We have to cover the fifth module theory. And TPOT, frankly speaking, we need to cover with the concept of lightings that we are going to cover it in third module and fourth module. That is here, see, illumination model, ambient light, what is diffuse reflection, specular and spawn model. Anyway, we are going to cover it up. By that time, we'll understand what are the basic light sources, right? With that, push pop, basically, if they ask you, why do we need to push and pop matrix, any sort of manipulation or the transformation that you are going to do, right? For example, any sort of transformation, Smith, maybe it is a translation, or maybe it is a scaling, maybe, right? That time, always you have to use a push or pop matrix, right? You have to use push and pop matrix within which you write a code for the primitive to be drawn, right? Push and pop, what it does basically, it push or pop like a stack, pop the current matrix stack. Okay, so why it is being used? To maintain the duplicate current matrix stack down by one, for duplicating the current matrix back again, you have to come back to the same position. No, so recurringly you are doing animation, that is transformation, that is translation, scale, again come back, translation, scale, come back. So if you could see this program, the same thing is being happening, right? You call a solid teapot. It is not that directly you call the solid teapot. For example, if I once again, I'll just comment the teapot without pushing pop, what happens? You have a teapot, no? You have called teapot in the display function. See, you called, I'll comment push matrix, pop matrix. What happens? Sometimes because of overlapping, you might get the output, but not always. Remember, see, the output is, now you are able to see the teapot. You may ask me the question, why it has come, though you have commented the push, it has come, why? Because already I had run the program. For the first time when you write this, you may not be able to analyze this solid teapot. Okay, so I request you to give the attendance in the chat session. I'll give the forward you the document on the teapot. Try to execute. I'll give the very simple program, not the big one. So if I give that also, you try to execute and see the changes or the effects of those programs. So give the attendance on the chat session.